Here's the problem. People view needy clients as needy clients. That's the problem, when really, they're a human being that just needs some help. So it's all about realizing all of the all the Ricky philosophies, bro.
I want you to know that this is my life. This is real. Relationships are universal.
How do you do this without lowering your personal standards? I mean, you say, you know, seeing what we can do for the client. How do you do this without you just like adapting yourself and your core values and what you stand for? Does that make sense?
Well, why would I have to lower my standards?
Here's what a lot of people end up doing is because they end up adapting to needy clients.
Oh yeah.
Versus, do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah. No. The needy clients are fine because here's the problem. People view needy clients as needy clients. That's the problem, when really, they're a human being that just needs some help, right? We're not there to do the deal. See, this is what's so funny. When I show property to a buyer who never buys anything, but I spend all that time with them, what happens? Well, they're like, they tell like four people. They're like, man, we didn't buy anything, but Ricky showed property to me all day this one time. You know, if I ever do buy anything, definitely gonna be Ricky. And you need to go talk to Ricky if you're looking to buy or sell something. And so like I see the back end of this stuff. Whereas if you really take a close look at that scenario, there's no such thing as a needy client because like I'm here to waste time with people. Like I'm literally here to waste time with people because even if this person doesn't do a deal with me, I feel like through the faith that I have that my intent is so high towards trying to actually help someone accomplish what they want to accomplish. If they just want to look at properties, great. Now, well, the flip side of that is this, Colton. A, closings happen every day. So if I'm doing my job to deal with that needy client for 5 hours and then taking the other 3 hours that I have and doing what I'm supposed to do to contact more people, and I'm getting my quota done for how many people I actually need to talk to on a daily basis, I know I'm gonna run into people that wanna buy or sell. So I don't have to worry about if that one client that wasted all my time is gonna do anything. Because chances are they will do something later. You know what I mean? So, yeah. I mean, there's so many different angles and different ways to look at that scenario. So like, on another note is like, I'm so good at targeting the highest quality prospects. And this is something that most agents really do not do a good job at because they're buying leads for one, like which is the most horrible thing you could do as far as an efficient real estate business. Unless you have a 20 person team and you want to spend $1 million a year to try to make $1 million a year, you know?
Yeah.
But on the flip side, I'm targeting property owners that own the type of property I want to sell. I don't buy leads, I don't have a lot of buyer leads coming in. The buyers that I represent are sellers who are selling and buying. Or they're referrals from property owners, right? So like this guy yesterday, that looked at $200,000 homes that may or may not buy anything, don't know, don't care. He was a referral from someone. So if someone sends me a referral, I'm gonna treat that person like they're gold, even if they want a $20,000 trailer an hour away, because I want them to go back to the person that referred them to me and say, man, you were right. Ricky goes over the top. You know what I mean? I want the person that referred them to me to know, cool, I can continue referring people to Ricky and he's gonna take care of them regardless of what the situation is. So I'm targeting my prospecting efforts, my business, you know, is focused around targeting the highest quality prospects, right? The price range I wanna sell in, the property owners who already own that property. Every person I call already owns the kind of property I wanna sell and the price range I wanna sell in. And so I don't get a lot of buyers. I show property, you know, probably like 2 to 4 times a month. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm not trying to get buyers. I'm focused on how, like if somebody wants to see a property, when you do it like this, you can be a single agent because you're not getting a lot of buyers, so you don't have to refer a lot of people out, right? I don't refer any buyers out. I take them all because I get very few, but they're all high quality. So it's all about efficiency, knowing closings happen every day, and just realizing all of the all the Ricky philosophies, bro. I mean, when you understand what I'm saying, bro, you cannot lose. And the trap that agents get in is that they feel like there's a scarcity of business, or there's only so much for me, and all the experienced agents are getting all the business, and it's just so far from reality, it's not even funny. We'll be right back.